Okay, for assisting with a bedpan, I would gather all the necessary supplies and enter the room and introduce myself to the patient and any family that may be there. I will go ahead and perform hand hygiene, and then identify the patient using two identifiers. I will go ahead and explain the procedure to the patient and kind of what's going to be going on. If the patient is able to, I will. Oh, and I will have provided patient privacy. So if the patient is able to help move themselves, I'll ask them to put their knees up and lift up their hips. And I'll put my non-dominant hand under the sacrum and slide the bedpan under their hips. And this is after ensuring that all the side rails have been up and that it's at a proper working height. Once the bedpan has been placed under the patient, I will go ahead and make sure that all the side rails are up and cover them back up and make sure that the call light is within reach so that I can go and they can have privacy. If the patient is not able to help move themselves, I will roll them onto their side and place the bedpan against their body and then help them to roll onto the bedpan. And then same things apply. I'll cover them back up with blankets. And before I leave, I'll place the call light by them and put the bed at the lowest height available. Once the patient uses their call light, I'll come back in and help them. And depending on their mobility, we'll help get the bedpan out. And I will place the bedpan and any tissues that were used, that were provided for them, on a chair that has been covered with a waterproof pad. And if they need any other cleaning up or help, I will go ahead and provide that for them. And I will cover the bedpan with a towel. If any of the linens have been soiled, I'll go ahead and get those changed and make sure that the patient is comfortable again. If I were to change linens, I'd make sure that I changed my gloves after using the dirty linens before putting the clean linens back on. I'd make sure that the patient is comfortable again, and then I would reapply gloves in order to get rid of the elimination. And after I will, before eliminating it, I'll make sure that I record the amount and the color and anything that may be unusual. I will get rid of everything into the toilet and wash it and make sure it's cleaned out. I'll then dispose of my gloves and perform hand hygiene. I'll make sure that everything is within reach that the patient may need and make sure that they're comfortable and that they have their call light. And then I will record everything that has happened and the time, as well as the amounts and anything particular about the stool.